We're going to head back to Austria, where our Europe correspondent Joy Reid is standing by at the Rowing World Champs. Hi, Joy. Tell us again about why this regatta is so important.
Yeah, sorry, I don't quite know what happened yet there before, but this is a huge event, on the rowing calendar every single year. But this year it's even more important because the top contenders, people who do well here at this regatta, will get an entry, or their boat will get an entry into the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. So there is a lot of focus here. In fact, it's attracted a record number of countries to enter boats this year. 80 different nations, 1,200 different athletes, and New Zealand sent over 43 rowers to compete in 14 different boat classes, and fingers crossed they're going to do quite well.
And some of these teams have already qualified, is that right?
Yeah, that's right. Well, today, just by making the finals, three boats have already qualified for the Olympics because depending on which class it is, they get, say, 8 spots or 11 spots to go through to the Olympics. So, amazingly, the women's pair, who are having a very, very good season, Kerry Gowler and Grace Prendergast, they finished first in their semi-final. In fact, the fastest time across both semi-finals. They have got a ticket to the final and, of course, now a ticket to Tokyo for their boat. Also, the lightweight doubles Skulls. They too finished first in their semi-final, first fastest time across the competition so far too, and they are going into the finals. But amazingly, this is the incredible part of today, the women's quad have qualified for the Olympics. Now I'll tell you why this is such a big deal. Just 5 weeks ago, these four women were put together in a boat. They are reserves currently for some of the other boats, and Rowing New Zealand thought, hey look, let's try them together. Now two of the women, Ruby Chu Kristen Goodshire, they are actually reserves for the women's eight, which means that they generally sweep. They row with one oar, but in the women's quad, they row with two. So quite a different technique. They have got together. Today was only the second time that they've ever raced 2,000 metres. They finished second in their semi-final and have qualified their boat for the Olympics, rather surprisingly too. In fact, Rowing New Zealand were quite surprised about this as well. Now, I caught up with them at the hotel, and here's a bit about what they had to say.
That's a pretty big deal. I mean, we have only been a crew for 5 weeks, so like, it's definitely exceeded expectations.
We haven't surprised ourselves. I think we all knew we had it in us, but it was just putting it down and really making sure it was a definite thing. So it's been really cool to be able to put that line in the sand and really say, yeah, we can do that, and yeah, be really proud of that.
Now, one thing I must point out is that they've qualified the boat for the Olympics, but they haven't actually qualified themselves to sit in the seat of that boat. They have trials at the beginning of next year to try and earn their spot. So just by doing so well today doesn't mean that they themselves are going to the Olympics, but the boat is, which of course will be good news for New Zealand rowing.
That is still a stunning achievement, isn't it? And Joy, there are some other Olympic and medal hopefuls over there as well.
Yeah, that's right. New Zealand is not short of top rowers. And this year of Emma Twigg, she in the single sculls, she has, she retired after a disappointing fourth in the Rio Olympics. She's come back to the sport and is the hot favourite for that event. Fingers crossed there. Also, you've got the women's eight. So that is the big boat there. They are also the hot favourite at this World Champs. And incredibly, Kerry Gowler and Grace Prendergast, who have already qualified in the women's pair, they are taking part too in the women's eight. So they're rowing in two different boats, which is quite a huge physical task for them. The Australians and the Canadians are doing that as well, but it is a big ask. Then you've got the women's double sculls, who are hopeful that they will make the podium and then go through to the Olympics. In fact, one person I was speaking to today said that the women are certainly doing their bit for New Zealand rowing at the moment, but I can't forget some of the men. You've got the men's pair, they're having a really great season, so we're hoping that they will qualify their boat and hopefully stand on the podium as well. Then you've got the single sculls, Robbie Manson. There's a lot of pressure on him. He's had a bit of a disappointing season. He is in the single there. Can he stand on the podium? Can he get a medal? And can he qualify that boat for the Olympics? Well, we certainly will hope so. The men's eight, well, they have today scraped through into the final. They had their repechage race today. They got second in that, which means that they got the last spot available for the final. There are only 5 of the 6 that will be racing in that final will make the Olympics. So, again, hoping that they can be in the top 5 on Sunday. So lots of potential.
And what happens if they don't qualify, Joy? What are the prospects there?
Well, it's not all over as such. There is something called a last chance regatta, which happens next year, just a couple of weeks before the Olympics, months before the Olympics itself. But no rower really wants to go to this. In fact, colloquially, it's called the regatta of death because it essentially means you have to peak twice in the season. You have to focus on qualifying for the Olympics and then get back up to the speed again so close to the Olympics. It is possible, but it's not something that anybody really wants to have to go to. And Rowing New Zealand has said that at this stage they won't be sending any boats to that unless there are exceptional circumstances. So it's not all over, but they are certainly hoping that the boats will do what they need to do here over the weekend.
All right, so much action to follow over there. Thanks so much for keeping us up to date. That's Joy Reid, our Europe correspondent, live in Austria.